So on the factory key fob, you're just going to tap the lock button 3 times. So you hit it 1, 2, 3. You'll see parking light confirmation. Give it a few seconds, you'll see the brake lights kick on and then the car will crank. There we go. So the first panel we're going to remove is this dash end cap right here, and this is just held on by a couple tabs and it will pop right out. What you're going to do next is go ahead and you're going to get underneath the back lip of this panel and it will pop up. The next thing we need to do is just pop this vent out. It's going to go right in between the dash and that black part, and you'll pop it loose and you'll hear that clip pop like that, and then this pops straight on. Once we have the vehicle prepped for the installation of the harness, I usually start right here behind the ignition switch. Ahead and take our portion of the T-harness that says ignition switch. You're gonna plug the factory connector into ours, and then our brown one goes back in to here. After you guys have the ignition switch plugged in, we're gonna go ahead and release the OBD2 connector back in here. The OBD2 is the purple plug underneath the dash. All right, so the OBD2 I have released, and it has a pretty good length on it here. Once you guys bring it down here, you're gonna plug the factory connector into the side of ours, and then our OBD2 with the purple on it, you're gonna pop it right back down into the dash. The last little bit of the harness that we need to install goes down here in the kick panel. It's the really long pigtail that has the blue, pink, and brown wires in it. As you can see, I tidy most of it up right here because there's a lot of room in the dash. Easy to zip tie out of the way, and you just route it down and bring it down to the kick panel, and then I'll show you where these hook up. It's really long because on the Cayenne, it has to go all the way over to the passenger side. We're down in the kick panel where we routed the long harness. There's 3 wires that we need to hook up. We want you guys to solder it. These are important connections. So as you can see, I stripped it back and I twisted the wire around, and I will solder this and tape it up after I'm done with the video. How this works is it has a little cap here, and you're going to insert it right over the nose of the key. So the loop portion of our key loop obviously is gonna go right around the portion where you stick the key in to turn it. And I find this easiest to come from the backside. There's gonna be a little access hole right here. Is this goes right on around the loop like that. So then you're gonna take the cover and you're gonna poke it right back on. And that will hold that wire in place. Please refer to the module programming video for the most up-to-date programming procedure, and also for proper connection of the wiring harness to the module. All right, we got the Macan all finished up. The first thing I'll tell you guys is to make sure that your headlight switch is set to the auto position. I do have the vehicle locked right now. So on the factory key fob, you're just gonna tap the lock button 3 times. So you hit it 1, 2, 3. You'll see parking light confirmation. Give it a few seconds, you'll see the brake lights kick on, and then the car will crank. There we go. Hit the unlock button, and now we have 45 seconds to get in and perform our secure takeover. If you guys exceed the 45 second window, the remote start will turn off when you open the door. So I hit unlock, we're gonna go ahead and open the door. The car stays running. From this point, what you're gonna do is get in, put the key in and turn it on. And now you get in, tap the brake, pull it out of park, and drive away.